Women to Women on BCTV is supported by the Women to Women program of the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance.
Welcome to the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance Women to Women Show. Women to Women, managed by the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance, encourages women to create connections, gain knowledge, open doors, and build strategic alliances, and much, much more. Our goal is to create more women leaders in Berks County by providing a forum where women from diverse backgrounds can learn, share, and mentor each other. I'm Alison Snyder, and I'm happy to be here today to talk to you a little bit about Women to Women and what we've got going on. So happy summer to everyone. Welcome on board. And I'd also like to introduce the Senior Director of Events and Special Programs at the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance, and of course, the Director of Women to Women, Rachael Romig. Hi, Rach.
Hello, happy summer to you too.
Yeah, so we're so excited to have some warmer weather. Looks like things are improving with COVID in a lot of our areas around us and in the companies. So things are looking a little bit brighter and cheerier. And we made it through the first half of 2021. And as we're looking better, I have to say, looking at your job, Rachael, being an event planner, it must have been a huge challenge over the course of the last year going through COVID. And I'm sure it's been very tough.
It definitely was really tough, especially for someone who's so outgoing. I'm an extreme extrovert, so not being with people has been so hard for me. So I'm really happy that I'm starting to see people again and people are coming into our office, and it's nice. But, you know, while we were having our programming, we kept it going every month. I think I talked about this on our last show a little bit, but we really transitioned extremely, extremely quickly. We didn't want, as Women to Women and the GRCA, we didn't want anyone to feel alone, you know, during such a hard time. And we had great programming scheduled and all the speakers hopped on and they were really helpful transitioning to virtual platforms using Zoom like today. Thanks, BCTV, for giving us the opportunity to keep doing things virtually when we can. I'm in Reading. Alison, you're out of East Penn. Usually it's a long commute, so this is great. But yeah, everyone, you know, stayed really engaged. The Women to Women group is just so engaged in general. The women that attend the events and the men, there are a couple, they just love being in the group. We love talking together, everything. So we kept it going. And in 2021, you know, we've had virtual. Now we're on a lull for the summer where we just do some fun stuff. We just had Lobster Fest in person, where it's a big just seafood fest, and that was super fun. Everyone was so excited.
That I missed that. I heard it was so great.
It was so great. Everyone was so excited to be back in person. It's BYOB, so people just were ready to have a good time. And we're doing Aqua Zumba with you during the summer. We have golf clinics, so it's really just casual summer fun. And now that we're back to being able to get together, people have been taking advantage. And as we look to the future, the rest of the year, hopefully things keep on a positive track, and we're going to have an in-person event and a virtual event in November and December, and only virtual in December because the weather could be bad. So I'm very happy that we're getting back together.
Yeah, and it's great to have the flexibility. I think one thing that we all learned through going through this COVID crisis is that you have to be adaptable and flexible, and having that flexibility to do in-person meetings versus, things like this, it's great, because sometimes it just can help with schedules and efficiency to do it virtually. But a lot of times, depending on what the venue is, it's better to be in person. So I know one thing that's coming up that we're hoping will be in person is our Women to Women Evening of Empowerment, which is always a fun cocktail event with a well-known speaker. So what's going to happen, Rachael? Is that going to be in person, or what are you thinking?
It's definitely going to be in person. Last year, we had it virtually with Michelle Poehler, who is very, very high energy. So I would have loved to have that in person, but she had an excellent virtual session and she had dancing and music. So I really want to take that fun to the in-person Evening of Empowerment this year. We're still on the hunt for a speaker, but you can definitely bet on this person being extremely fun and engaging. Starting to look at some venues around the area that are indoor, outdoor, because October these days is still really nice. So, you know, by the end of October, it's starting to get chilly, but we can do an indoor-outdoor thing and be spaced out and in person and just have a great time. When you come to the Evening of Empowerment, which happens every year in the fall, you can expect to see some of our sponsors at tables to learn about what they do, networking over cocktails and appetizers, and then we have this amazing speaker. And normally afterwards, the speaker is able to take photos with you, meet you, or sign their book if they have a book. So yeah, I'm very, very excited to find the speaker. So if anyone out there has a cool idea for a fierce lady with an inspirational story, we'd love to hear it.
That's great. That's great. Thank you. So changing gears a little bit, let's talk about Lean in Circles. So they just concluded for this past year at the GRCA, and how did it go?
This year we had one circle. The facilitator is Joni Noggle. She owns Noggle Associates. She is also a Vistage peer group facilitator. So she's an excellent, excellent facilitator for these groups. And she's been a facilitator with us since we started these circles. So about 5-6 years. Like I said, yeah, you said it did just end in July. It usually runs from October to July. And every month they meet once a month. There were 12 women in this circle. And it was definitely a little different this year because for a portion of the year it was in person and then COVID hit, continued and they were virtual. So the group itself met in person if they were comfortable and then just zoomed in at anybody else. But it went really, really well. Some people disappeared for a little while because it was just tough with working through the pandemic, but it went really great.
Awesome. So I think a lot of people in our audience, maybe some of them never heard about what a lean-in circle is, maybe a new concept. So can you tell us a little bit, Rachael, what exactly happens in a lean-in circle?
That's a great question. So circles are small groups of women who, like I said, they meet regularly to learn new skills, network, and sort of encourage and mentor one another. They're intentionally curated. So as we get applications, we place women in circles that makes the most sense. Maybe no competitor things. We see where they are in the like hierarchy of their company so that you're talking to other women who have similar aspects of their role and in the same kind of stage of life. They're facilitator led. So there's constant structure. Keeping you on track, making sure you're getting the most out of it. So that's why we use a professional. And there are about 12 to 14 women in the circle, and they're leaning in to learn, grow, and support each other in a communicative and a trusting atmosphere. Everything is always confidential in these circles. So because women talk about, you know, what's happening usually in their professional realm, but sometimes personal creeps in because, you know, that's how our world is. Women take on a lot, and we talk about that. So, but let me actually show a video here and have Sheryl Sandberg tell you more about the circles. Sheryl Sandberg and Rachael Thomas started the Lean In Circles, and Sheryl Sandberg actually used to be a COO of Facebook. So let me pop it on here for you. And you can find this video on the Berks Women to Women website.
Hi, I'm Sheryl Sandberg, and I'm excited to invite you to join a lean-in circle. Lean-in circles are small peer groups that allow you to learn and share in an atmosphere of confidentiality and trust. There's lots of evidence from book clubs to weight loss groups to team projects that we all achieve more in groups than we do as individuals. That's why we're forming lean-in circles, and we invite you to form one or join one. There are groups of 8 to 12 peers that agree to meet together once a month, both to focus on sharing and focus on education. Working with experts from around the world, including the Clayman Institute on Gender Research at Stanford, will give you education modules. You can learn how to negotiate, how to communicate, how to navigate your career. And we'll also support you as you share experiences with each other, supporting each other as a group you lean in. I'm excited to have you join a lean-in circle as we all lean in together.
That, that sounds really impactful, Rachael. And I can tell you, I participated a few years ago in one of the GRCA's groups, leaning groups, and it was really great. I really enjoyed the fact that we had people from all different companies there. We all had the agreement that what we would talk about there would be kept confidential, like you described. And we were really able to help each other out. And just having somebody that doesn't even have any prejudices or knows anything about you can listen to your story or your situation and try to help give some helpful advice. It's just always great to have contacts like that that can help you through some of the difficult things that we all deal with, either in our work lives or our personal lives. And we, as you mentioned, we worked through both of those things. And it was interesting. I know in my circle, you know, obviously I have an HR background. There were some people that had some harassment situations going on in the workplace they didn't know how to handle. I was able to help them with that. So, you know, it was great. And there were people that had some insight with some things I struggled with that were able to help me as well. So they're really, I can't say enough good things about them. But my question is, if somebody is interested in getting involved in an upcoming circle with the GRCA, how can they get involved?
So before we finish up, I'm going to put up my contact information so that people can reach out and also go on to the Berks Women to Women website where you can reach out to me. We do have a lean-in info session coming up on August 17th at our YMSing office location. And we actually take an hour and a half to 2 hours and run through what a real circle is like so that you get a real sense of what's going to happen. The circles themselves, when they meet for the 2 hours each month, every other month there's exploration or there's education. So as Sheryl Sandberg had said, there are modules that leanin.org actually curates for us and passes out to us and all the lean-in circles all over the world. They're all over the world. And that is how to negotiate. Maybe there's a video that's made and a worksheet that everyone needs to watch in advance and they complete together. So they work through those skills, building up your skills for the workplace. And then there is exploration where exactly what you were just talking about, Alison, you can share what's going on in your world. And if you have something coming up or you want to ask for a raise or you're going to go for a new job, you know, to just work through, like, I'm really nervous. What are the best tactics? And you help each other. And by offering up something from what's happening in your life, you really have that, you know, like that action item you need to make. Like once you get that advice, they're going to follow up with you next month and see how you did. Because they're all obviously rooting for you, but they want to know, you know, that your circle members want to know and support you, but it holds you accountable for making those positive changes in your life. So they're just so amazing. I've never been in a circle, you know, because I kind of run the circle. So if I were to join a circle, it'd have to be out in a different town, but I would love to, because there are some women who from 5 years ago when they started, they still meet outside of circles as a group, because they just bonded so tightly and they've been helping each other through their lives, which I think is just amazing. You know, whether it's your network or your tribe, you know what I mean? Like the women around you, who you have to surround yourself with, those that will lift you up. And that's what these lean-in circles turn into. So
there's never to have enough people in your tribe, right?
Yeah, you can never have enough people, and the good ones. Like I saw something recently on Instagram through Women to Women. Our Instagram is Berks W2W, if you want to follow us. I was scrolling through about to post something, and I had seen that there was a quote like, you should surround yourself with people who challenge you. Because that's how you grow. If the people around you are just like, la, 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 you know, you stay la, 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 la. That can be hard for some people because you've been friends with the same people and have had the same people in your circle, but widening your circle is necessary. So the word circle is just used so often. But yeah, you can check out our website, berkswomentowomen.com. You can register for the lean-in info session for August 17th. It's free to attend. It is from 8:30 to 10:30, and it's going to be in the morning just so you can start your day off right, and see if you're interested. The Lean In Circle curriculum, even when you go through a circle one time, you can go through for years to come because the curriculum changes year over year and you're learning new skills. So I always like to mention that because people think that once they go through, they're good. There's always more to learn. So year after year, we have great things ready to go. So, but thank you for sharing your experience in a Lean In. It really, what I would love to do is make videos of women giving their testimonies because they're so impactful, these circles.
Yeah. If you could put like the black bar in front of their face and just hear their voice or muffle their voice and just hear some of those, that it would be great. Especially right when they're in the thick of it. Because I'm telling you, there were some tearful situations. And then the next month when we regrouped, how thankful the women were that of the advice and the help and the support that they got from the other women in their group.
Yeah, and I always like to tell this story, which it doesn't happen all the time, but there was a woman that went through a circle who at the end of the circle realized she was not doing what she was passionate about. She quit her job, went and found a new job and what she really wanted to do. It just really, it developed her as a person and she was able to change her life based on that. So, you know, and if you are a company that's watching this and you maybe are interested in having something like this within your company and do it for a sector of the women in your departments, we can do that. Women to Women does do internal Lean In Circles as a service, and we help you find a facilitator. And we work through not only the curriculum that Lean In offers, but we look at the core values of the company, and everything is tailored around the, you know, what the goals are of the company and how you can live the values of the company while also professionally advancing. So those are available as well and have been quite popular because they're in-house.
Right, right. And I can tell you, I know we're really excited. Last year, when COVID hit, we had had a couple speakers set up to come in to talk to us. I know Adrian Turner was going to come talk to our group. So we're excited to get that rolling again now that things are loosening up and we can start to do in-person meetings again. So we're excited for that.
Yeah, definitely. Let me actually, while we close up, just pop up my contact information.
Okay, wonderful.
If anyone wants to contact me, feel free to give me a call. Or like I said, go on BerksWomenToWomen.com and you can check out our Lean In page and you'll be directed right to me. And there's more information there as well, including an application for the Lean In Circles. They're starting in October 2021, just like we always do. So we take the summer off. So we'd reach out.
And if you can't make that meeting, Rachel, I'm sure somebody can still apply to be part of the Lean In. Is that correct?
Definitely. And we are going to try and record the Lean In info session so that we can share it in the future for people that can't come, just so they can see and understand how a circle works and feels.
Well, Rachel, I want to thank you so much for being here on the show today. And remember, if you're interested in becoming a member of Women to Women, all you have to do is visit BerksWomen2Women.com and sign up to be on the email list. And then like Women to Women on Facebook and Instagram, as Rachel just mentioned, to stay in the loop about upcoming events, inspiration, and ways to connect with other women. And so we want to thank all of you for your kind attention today. We really hope we get to see you at one of our upcoming events. And if you're listening today, come to Aqua Zumba tonight. It'll be fun.
It'll be fun.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Women to Women on BCTV is supported by the Women to Women program of the Greater Reading Chamber Alliance.